me, I'll have life. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awakening, he will raise up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord, and if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labor.
And also with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this celebration, Lisa Harbaugh, and also welcome those who are watching us on the live stream. You can follow along in a worship bulletin that you can download by going to our website, www.stpeterschurch.net, and go to the worship online page, and you can download the bulletin there. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Lisa. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad, the desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance and with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty grounds springs of water. The haunts of the jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be built there. It shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come upon it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Turning to page 4, let us all say together Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble at its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our stronghold. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown. God shall help her at the break of day. The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken. God has spoken, and the earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now and look upon the works of the Lord, what awesome things he has done on earth. It is he who makes war cease in all the world. He breaks the bow
and shatters the spear,
and burns the shields with fire. Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. So, we do not lose heart. Even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure, because we look not at what can be seen, but what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this tent we groan, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, if indeed when we have taken it off, we will not be found naked. For while we are still in this tent, we groan under our burden, because we wish not to be unclothed, but to be further clothed, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. He who has prepared us for this very thing is God, who has given us the Spirit as a guarantee. So we are always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us say together Psalm 23, found on page 7. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us stand for the sequence hymn, A Mighty Fortress.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them in also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please be seated. I thank you for enduring our protocols and all its our social distancing and all that. I'm glad we are able, though, to have folks in the church for this celebration. Sorry, we have a cantor behind the organ that's doing our singing for us since we can't sing in the church. And I thank Barry for doing that, too. Today we celebrate the life of Lisa Harbaugh. Now, I did not have the honor of knowing Lisa prior to her illness, but when she and Greg first came to St. Peter's a while ago, I was able to experience her great wit, her caring demeanor, her love of music, and her great faith in our Lord. And I've learned much more about her life from her family over these past few days. Lisa was full of effervescence. She was jovial, she was affectionate, she was compassionate, and she was full of life, able to light up any room she entered. She loved people. She loved to engage them and laugh with them and enjoy their company, and people loved her and the way she sought to help them. She had a free spirit, a sense of adventure, and a spirit of goodness and curiosity. She loved music, from playing the baritone horn in high school to singing in choirs throughout her life. She sang, and she sang with gusto and purpose. I suspect that one of the motivations in coming to St. Peter's and staying at St. Peter's when Greg and Lisa moved to the Eastern Shore was to enjoy this robust music ministry that we offer here. Even in the pandemic, when choirs can't sing in churches, we have found ways through cantors and virtual choirs to keep music as part of our worship and community experiences, and something that Lisa no doubt approved of. Her son Zach told me stories of how Lisa loved to go on trips, and not only that, Lisa loved to plan trips. She liked adventure, she liked to be organized, and so she would take these gifts and enthusiastically plan family trips to many different places, car trips, plane trips, that brought the family together, generated many great memories. She loved the outdoors, taking hiking and bicycling and kayaking adventures, and she cared about God's creation and saw the importance of protecting and caring for our environment. Her amazing interpersonal skills, her gifts of organizing served her well in her different career positions. And she thrived and helped others to thrive as well. She had persistence, determination to see things through. Her great love, though, was for her family. For her son Zach and grandson Logan, she loved being a mother and a grandmother, showing her love to them. And she had great love for her husband, Greg, for 48 years. My wife and I have something in common with Lisa and Greg, because they met in high school, we met in high school, and I'll tell you, when you're that long, you are just soulmates for life. And Lisa and Greg loved each other so much, cared for each other, were there for each other till her last breath. Their life journeys have been with one another. And we who love them saw the joy of their marriage, their love deep and genuine. And Lisa loved the Lord. Her faith was great. As a spouse of a member of the clergy, she has a unique perspective on God's people, seeing them do good and seeing experience them in other ways, maybe not so good. Perhaps holding her tongue at times, supporting her husband's ministry, and carving out her relationship with God that could be challenging or complex at times. But I know this, even while her physical condition deteriorated in her last years, when she could, she was bound and determined to be in church, worshiping in community, receiving the sacrament. Such is her faith, a model for other believers. And when she could no longer come to church, she eagerly awaited receiving Holy Communion from clergy and lay Eucharistic visitors, knowing and desiring that she remained sacramentally part of the body of Christ. And now our Lord, the Good Shepherd, has come to bring her to eternal life. As Christians, we believe that in death, life is changed and not ended. And Lisa has now come into the loving arms of our Lord and is experiencing the unfiltered glory of God. In our first lesson from Isaiah, we have a description by Isaiah of God welcoming back the Jewish people from exile. It is a joyful scene on the holy way, with a desert rejoicing and blossoming, the crocus blossoming abundantly with rejoicing and singing. I can just imagine Lisa in her holy journey with the Good Shepherd to eternal life, experiencing the blossoming of creation, reminding her of the many outdoor strolls and adventures and surrounded by the joy of singing. And Isaiah says, the eyes of the blind shall be opened, the ears of the deaf unstopped, the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. And I reflect that in death, the mortal bonds of time and space are released, and the physical limitations and pain and suffering are no more. And Lisa, who has been suffering, suffers no more, and is now able eternally to sing for joy and to leap like a deer. St. Paul in our second lesson tells us not to lose heart. For any affliction in this life is momentary compared with the eternal weight of glory that is beyond all measure, which awaits us at our deaths, and which we believe Lisa is now experiencing. The eternal weight of glory that is beyond all measure. She is now clothed in the heavenly garment among the saints, where that which is mortal is swallowed up, St. Paul says, by life. Lisa has heard the voice of the Good Shepherd, who knows her as one of his own. She is forever in his loving care. He has laid down his life for his sheep. And through his death, he has conquered death. And through his resurrection, he has assured us the way to eternal life. So let us rejoice, my brothers and sisters, that Lisa is now experiencing the glory of God, the promise of resurrection. And may we too look forward to our last day when we, like Lisa, will be raised to eternal life with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Turning to page 9 of your bulletins, let us stand, and in the assurance of eternal life given at baptism, let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. For our sister Lisa, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Lisa, and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Lisa, who is reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ. Thank you all for being part of the service. We will be having Holy Communion in just a few moments, and all are welcomed at the table of the Lord. Due to the pandemic, we will only be receiving the bread and not the cup, but it's certainly a full communion with that. We believe in the communion of saints, and the communion of saints is those that are here. We're part of the saints of the church, and we are united with those saints who have gone before us in Jesus Christ. That's what communion of saints is, and it's really well symbolized by Holy Communion, when Christ unites both those who have gone before us and those that are here in that great heavenly banquet. So I encourage you to come up at the time when the usher instructs you to come up. We just need to social distance. There's like little crosses where you can stand. There's no kneelers, so please stand. And you're all welcome at the table of the Lord. And now, the offertory hymn is The King of Love, My Shepherd Is. Please stand as you're able. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to our Lord, our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with blessed Peter and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. You may be seated. Let us say the prayer for those unable to receive Holy Communion. Faithful God, in the wonder of your wisdom and love, you fed your people in the wilderness with the bread of angels, and you sent Jesus to be the bread of life. Though I cannot consume these gifts of bread and wine, I thank you that I have received the sacrament of Christ's presence, the forgiveness of sins, and all the benefits of Christ's passion. By the power of the Holy Spirit, may I embody your desire, be renewed for your service through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. You may come forward for communion. Thank you. please stand? Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love, you have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. And now... Neither sigh, but light. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so you ordained what you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, and even at the grave we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sorrow and pain are no more, neither sigh, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, We commend your servant Lisa. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who make this earthly pilgrimage with us. So be swift to love, make haste to do kindness, shower abundant hospitality on friend and stranger, walk in justice, that you may follow the path of mercy and love, and the blessing of God who comes to us unbidden, who for our lives was broken, and whose spirit we are guided into wholeness and holiness of life, be upon you and those whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ.